What's up, and thanks once again for tuning into our show, Morgellons Disease Discussion and Microscopy Videos. Today, we want to talk about the origins of Morgellons. The unknown cat is back, and yeah, he had a breakout because SSKI does not work on Morgellons. It is not fungal in nature. But I'm glad to see that he got out to Colorado. I'm planning on doing that myself pretty soon here. And we are advocating for legal access to medical cannabis in the state of South Carolina. Go to www.sccompassion.com and you can see more about our efforts there. So, of course, I'm making this video in response to the unknown cat because he's got a video with a very cool intro that suggests that he understands the origin of Morgellons or has a theory, is what he says. I'll be fair. But he did say a few things in that video that for me was an aha moment. And those in particular was when he was talking about growing up with slow healing lesions. And when he was talking about his recent breakout again. And he was talking in particular about the long gelatinous plugs inside the pores. I've seen the scars on your skin, Charles, and, you know, you've seen mine. We've got the same thing. It's Morgellons. But the difference is that you think it's fungal, but I know. Because science has demonstrated at least half a dozen times in peer-reviewed studies that this right here is caused by Spirochete Bacteria. Let me say this again. Spirochete Bacteria. The bacteria, the reason why they call it a spirochete is because it spirals. It's called Borrelia. Borrelia Burgdorferi. Borrelia hermsii. It's also got the tick-borne relapsing fever. You can have several kinds of Borrelia infections. I think we have over 300 known kinds of Borrelia. Borrelia. They call it Borrelia because it bores into the skin. I'm glad you're talking about biofilm because that's my thing, man. I'm the biofilm bandit. Look it up, dude. I took a course from the University of Copenhagen in Denmark, right, on bacterial infections, chronic bacterial infections. And you know what causes them? Biofilm. But it's not on your face, man. It's under your skin, bro. Because what happens is these bacteria get together, right? The Borrelia are really good at this. Once they bore into the tissue, they build a home for themselves there. No kidding. That's what biofilm is. It's literally a mansion for this bacteria. And they build it. And then guess what? They invite their friends in. Bartonella, right? Babesia, the fungus. They invite them all in, right? But the thing is, Charles, when we do biopsies on Morgellons patients, there's only one thing that's consistently there, and it's not fungus, okay? Let's go back for just a second, though, and talk about these, I can't think about that word. What's it called? Well, I call them plugs. Some people call them projections. That's the word, projections. I don't know. Vehicular casts is what they are, okay? Get this. This bacteria, right, when it's in your skin, it goes inside the skin cells. Fibroblasts is what they call them. Because those fibroblasts, they make new skin, okay? Keratinocytes, they make new skin. They make new keratin, right? The fibroblasts, they're epithelial cells. The bacteria goes inside them. And they trigger irregular expressions, okay? Now, those sores that you got, those things that are stinging, that feel like splinters, I'm going to blow your mind here, okay? Those are ingrown hairs all over your body. Because when you pull those projections out and you put them up under a microscope, unknown cat, you see the little hair at the very end, at the very tip of that gelatinous extrusion. Because that bacteria causes your hair to grow in reverse. It causes, right, instead of getting a scab that grows out and over, okay, it grows in reverse and down in towards your muscles. You know how I know this? Science. Not just any kind of science, peer-reviewed studies. That means several scientists have looked at the data and they said, we can't find anything wrong with it. Because when they cut into these biopsies of Morgellons patients' skin tissue samples, They don't find fungus, my man. Those extrusions, those aren't worms, okay? Because I've sent them into the lab before, and you know what they told me? That's human protein. These studies that I'm referencing, human protein, keratin and collagen, those follicular casts, plugs in the pores, they look like worms, but they're not. They're not fungus, my man. That's your own skin proteins. We find that bacteria consistently. Not just any kind of Borrelia, though. We find Borrelia burgdorferi, the bacteria that causes Lyme disease. Remember talking about being out in the backyard and playing in the rural area? You know, was you pulling any ticks off you? Was you pulling any ticks off you, my man? I'm going to leave a study in the bottom of this video, okay? Because guess what? Morgellons can be transmitted from mother to child, and often it is. Did your family serve in the military? My dad was in Okinawa. He was overseas, where they have their own kind of strain of Lyme disease over there. I think it's Borrelia miyamotoi. Get this, right? How many people every year get HIV in the United States? Would it be surprising for you to know that it's 29,000 every year? And then how many people you know get Lyme disease every year in the same country? Would it surprise you that in the same year, 29,000 people got HIV? 300,000 people got Borrelia burgdorferi? And the reason why I say Borrelia burgdorferi is because there are four known strains of Borrelia that cause Lyme disease, and we're only counting one at the CDC, and that's Borrelia burgdorferi. We're not counting the other three strains, like maybe the Borrelia miyamotoi that my dad maybe picked up in the Okinawa. So what I'm telling you, my man, is that this Borrelial infections is very common. And all these answers about the origins and everything, we don't have all of them. But consistently, when we do a biopsy on these skin tissue samples, we find Borrelia burgdorferi consistently. We don't always find fungus. In fact, rarely do we find fungus in these skin tissue samples. But we consistently find Borrelia burgdorferi. Hey, if you like my videos, hit that like button. Smash into that subscribe. Hit the bell icon. We are going to be doing some cool interviews here. We're lining them up. If you're interested in the truth about scientific Morgellons, or the scientific truth about Morgellons, hit that subscribe. Hit that bell icon so you can get notified. Leave a comment down below so we can discuss what we talked about in this video. Of course, I'm going to leave some links in the description to what I was discussing about this video. Charles, I wish you the best of luck, man. I keep making those kick-ass intros. Those are fun.